Okay, take out the last page of the story, the 100 dresses, part second.
Every time. why that one half had been so nice to them and on the other hand they were behaving so rudely and making fun of Mona. Again tears blurred from her eyes. Now what she did is, she rubbed her tears off and started looking at the picture more deeply. When she looked at the picture, she realized one more thing, that the face, the features, the hair, the head, everything looked similar to Maddie. She realized that not only Wanda had worn the dress for her, but also the girl who's wearing the dress is just similar to Maddie. That means while they were teasing her, while she was in school, they were teasing her, she was observing them and she had made them a drawing. And the moment she realized that the sketch is similar to her, she ran to Peggy's house. The moment she reached Peggy's house, she asked for the sketch from Peggy. When she looked at it, she found that the sketch is similar, the girl is similar to Peggy. So both these sketches were made for both the girls by Wanda Petrowski during the days when she was made fun of by them. Read. Peg, let me see your picture. What's the matter? Look, she drew you. That's you. The head, the face of the picture did look like you, Peggy. What did I say? Said Peggy. She must have really liked us anyway. So what Peggy said? Peggy said that she must have liked anyway. See, on the other hand, Maddie is there and on the other hand is Peggy. Both of the girls have different perceptions regarding the thing going on. Maddie is feeling guilty, but we don't see that Peggy is really guilty of what she has done. She brings away the tears that came every time she thought of Wanda standing alone in that sunny spot in the schoolyard, looking solidly means very calm, over at the group of laughing girls, and she had walked off after she had said, sure, 100 of them all like her. So, she realized that yes, she liked us. She was nice to us. But what we were doing, whatever we had done bad for her. She could recall the memory of Wanda Petrowski standing at the schoolyard, looking out at the laughing girls playing what? Playing hopscotch. She could recollect of Wanda's persona with a blonde, like with long hair, very calm, very sweet, very polite, little into her. Into her means a person who's not able to share feelings with others. So little into her child and very nice to them throughout the story. So here, Maddie couldn't stop her tears falling down because every time she thought of Wanda, she would feel bad. Bad for doing wrong to her. Bad for not speaking up against the law. Bad for not taking the stand for Wanda, for being quiet. So, this is a sensitive story where we got to know this. Wanda Petrowski, who did not let those bad comments make any kind of effect on her. She worked on her skills. She worked on those artistic skills throughout. Both girls had been teasing her, but standing there, she was observing them. She observed their features, their hair, their looks. That is why she was able to make those sketches beautifully drawn on a white sheet. Even if she's there, sitting at the corner of the class, she was observing everyone. She was observing the classroom. So, you never know what's going on in the mind of anyone until and unless you know that person very closely.
You cannot make judgments about anyone without knowing them very closely. You never know what skills or what talent the person has. So make sure, and by this lesson we learn, that do not say anything bad to anyone, and even don't tolerate anything bad happening in front of them. Always speak for the right, stand up against the wrong, and do not be quiet, because do not be silent, because doing wrong is equal to being silent against the world. So this is a lesson that we had learned from Wanda, who is a very kind-hearted girl, very mature in her nature, and very talented, we could say highly intelligent, observing everything, and outside her appearance, nobody could even realize that she was a great artist and a brilliant sketch maker. So, this is what the lesson says, that don't judge a book by its cover. Even here in the class, there would be many hidden talents to do what you know. And you might also not know that what talents you have. Slowly, when you try new things, then you will realize, oh, I'm good at it. Oh, I can be good at it, or I'm good at it. So, life is all about experiencing new things. Life is all about discovering new things. But here in the lesson, Wanda had already discovered her favorite thing of making sketches and drawing, that she had done brilliantly, and gave the answer with love and care. She could have spoken to them in rude way, but no. She knew that what is more important is to focus on her, to focus on oneself rather than what others say about her. So that was the biggest positive point that she had, is focusing on oneself, one skills, and not focusing on what others think about her, because she knew that she is good at it. And even if somebody said something to her, she hardly bothered. She replied them in a very calm way, very natural way. And here we come to the end of the lesson, the 100 dresses, part 1 and part 2. And we learned a lot from this character, Wanda Petrovsky, written by Elizabeth. Read the last two paragraphs once again. Write out a few questions. Answer the following questions in 100 to 120 words. Question 1. Win the heart of her classmates.
end of the story. At the end of the story. Last question. What was the effect of the letter? What was the effect of the letter of Varna's father? Of Varna's father on Miss Mason. On Miss Mason. How did she react to it? How did she react to it? Come to page number 80 of your book. Page 80. You will come across this exercise. The words are given in that box where you will find both positive and negative words. You will have to fill this circle writing positive words on top and writing negative words below. So please, with the help of the dictionary, do this exercise right now.